Welcome on Revelation. Today I want to show you a newbie tutorial, especially for new players. I'm here on my test environment. You see, we have a lot of characters for test. So let's start as we would like to start on our normal server. I want to show you today the first step for combat profession, because so many players have, after the first 4 hours, are very frustrated here with the combat mechanics, because they are missing to learn very special things you need to know in Star Wars Galaxies. So here is our first newbie tutorial, and our fourth, we have here a new newbie dungeon for the first steps. Okay, so I choose here now a Zabrak. I take the default settings here. I choose now the profession brawler or marksman, for example, because I want to start here a combat profession. So let's. I want also to take here the random name. And when you see here, I left out now the new player tutorial. You should do that too, because we explain here everything now here in this video tutorial. After you created your character, you started on this station. That's the new player station. You can toggle with the Alt key here your cursor, that you can move around freely with your mouse, or either you can use here the toggling with Alt. When you toggle Alt, you have here also the mouse pointer and are able here to activate your skills. So first of all, I want to change some settings, because that it's a little bit nicer here. You can drag and drop here over these things, and also here we can make this a little bit closer, brighter, and here we can, with drag and drop, expand our tool button bar here to 2 slots, and that's very useful because you will need it. You can also toggling here between 6 different bars, where you can tap your combat skills, for example. The same is depending here on your experience. I think somewhere here is also the possibility that you can choose the things. That depends a little bit on your mods, because that's not so good at the moment, because I wanted to show you something special. Because when you press this here, it's Control C, it's your character sheet. You will see what this bar don't show at the moment. We have a lot of heals and a lot of action, and our mind is not so well. And here on this station, we have the one-time possibility without an image designer to change our attributes. So we make a stat migration. I disable here the help. And heals, strength, constitution, action, quickness, stamina are buffed normally by doctors. We have also, for starters, some small buff bots online, so you can lower here your skills. Mind, focus and willpower is provided by dancers or musicians. You need to be in a group with them and watch, listen then to their performance. And we have here also in the game, all creatures will hit you on heals, action and mind. So you see, when you have only 500 minds, you are very fast down without buffs. So I decided now here to remove some of my action points, maybe to 900, same with the heals. Rise here my mind also to 800, that it's a little bit better here. And when you go here with the tooltip text in this window, the stats will show you also for what they are. So to strength, constitution, for example, stamina, quickness and focus, willpower, they are that your skills are not cost so many, and for your regeneration rates also here. So we make a good mix. I think during the your game time you will choose here a lot of more. Okay, you see we have now heals, action and mind are over 800. Okay, we are pleased with that. We have also battle fatigue. You need to keep an eye on that, because with battle fatigue you have then it's inflicted your combat skills. When it's over 250 points and more, you have not so good chance to hit and so on. You can remove battle fatigue also on entertainer or dancer or musician, and also some stim packs from doctors are able here to heal small amounts of battle fatigue. Okay, we are finished with that. The next thing is we go here under Control O. Then we have some options. I want to change here my interface color, for example. Maybe Tino Life, it's a bit different color. Normally when you are here in general, you can ask in a general chat the people. When you are not able to type, maybe you need to toggle with the Alt key here, and then you can type something in. No one will react here, because I'm the only one on my test environment. So when I'm go to the general, I am like modify, and I want to see here the system messages. I want to see the instant message, that's the tells when people tell me something, and I want to see the normal chat messages here. Okay, I think on our server it's a special chat here. Okay, so we are prepared. We have one tab where we can see now all our tells. We have adjusted a little bit our environment. Maybe we can go to our radar station. You can move that here with drag and drop also a little bit around. And maybe it's 64 meters. I will rise it up to 256, because it's very good to see red dots later, because they are aggressive towards us. So the next thing is we open our inventory. It's Control E. You see we have a starter backpack. We are able here to make some color changes. Then we don't look like a superstar newbie here. So we make here one color a little bit better. An armor smith can alternate here all the colors. So we make here only our colors in the primary colors. So we equip here with double click. It takes a while until you can equip the next item. You can also press your mouse and go to the equip menu. And when you open now here this thing here, then a new window pops up with more information about items. You see we have here our armor with 10,000 hit points that will decay over the time when we are under attack, when we are hit by NPCs. And here we see the resistance. That's only starter armor here. Composite armor from players have 90% resistance and are much better, or 80% or 70%. You are able here to equip very fast things, and also your starter weapons here, they are very low, but I think it will work for the beginning. We equip now our travel bag, and let's take a look. We have Neutron Pixies, it's a drug. When we need additional here, 1000 heals, 500 action. When we are a little bit in trouble, we can use this guy's here. So I put emergency guide here in my quick bar. We have small stim packs which we can use when we are later medic. We will learn that soon enough. I put that also here in my button bar. I want to become here a brawler with a pole arm, for example. So I equip the wooden stuff, and then let's take a look for later. We have here also some buffs for melee defense, range defense, melee accuracy and ranged accuracy. Accuracy is the value which you need in for attacking that you hit monsters, especially in the beginning. It's very hard because your skills are quite low. When you go here to your skill window, Control S, you will see that here you have only Nova's Prowler. Here you see your available skills on your character, and you see we have here only 10 points in pole arm accuracy. That will rise up, I think, to 180 or 200 later. So we are not hitting very well at the moment. Let's take a look here on this box. We have some skills: Berserk, Center of Being. We can use a dagger. We have Intimidate. We have One Hand Lunge, Pole Arm Lunge, Taunt, and so on. Okay. Then I show the experience monitor because I want to look for the pole arm skills, like here. Then we go here under the skills, abilities and commands, and let's take a look here what we have. We switch to the combat tab, and you will see here we have peace, very useful when we need to run back. This is our burst run where we can run back very fast. So I put also the peace directly near to that because we run back and press peace that the monsters are not following us. We need here two-handed. We have no two-handed. That's for unarmed. We need here for us the pole arm skill. I put that in here. Sometimes you must try it a little bit. Important skills is Intimidate, because here when a target is intimidated, they are not able to hit their targets as often. A very, very useful skill, primary at slot one here. When we fighting against an enemy, we always look that we get Intimidate on him, so his combat strength is much lower, and it will help you very, very, very lot. When you look at Warcry, the combat move can increase the round time of your opponent's attack and if slowing them down, so the attack time is slowed, as also a very good skill. And we have here, let's take, that's okay, that's all. We have here also under others, Center of Being. So when we I triggered, when I use it, it strengthen up my defense. But you will see here it only holds at the moment for 3 seconds. The time will rising later, but at the moment we have here some troubles because all 3 seconds triggering that skill is not so useful for us. So we make our first macro for the combat. We stay in the combat browser, go under the tab macro, and you see I will delete him here. We make new macros that you can see it. I make here a new macro. I'm choosing here now an icon for my skill, maybe like this one. I name it COB for Center of Being. Then it should make a command. The command is Center of Being. When I type in center, it's enough. Then I need a semicolon. Then I make the next command with a slash. I type pause 2. It's a delay of 2 seconds. And at least I make now a macro call of COB. So our macro make a center of being. After two pause of 2 seconds, we call the same macro again. So we have a loop. And all 2 seconds, we have now triggered our defense. We put that here. It's very important for us. And in cases we want to dump that, we make also a new macro. It's a dump macro. We call it maybe dump. I use this icon here, and it's only a slash dump that we can get rid of the macros. So let's test it. We trigger our center of being. You see, then this writing centered came over us. Now it's gone away, and now we have the defense again. Now we make the dump macro and see one pause command chain is dumped, and it's over here with our macro. So we have not all the time here the text triggering. Okay, guys, then let's start. We go now to our Charger Corporation doctor, and you have a new option here. Please buff me and send me to the start dungeon. Yes, we want to go to the Star Dungeon. Yes, buff us and welcome to the Star Dungeon. You see, we have here a new player message for the server. Normally, people will say now welcome. You can talk to them with in general chat, and you will see they are very, very helpful with you. You see here in this picture line, we have our buffs, mind buffs, musical buffs. It's the normal starter buff. When we go in our character sheet, we will see now that our values, the modifier, are enhanced. So we are at the moment with that buff a lot stronger than before. And you can get your buff later in medical centers or cantinas from Cherka doctors or from the Bacta girls, that's NPCs with beginner buffs, or you ask player doctors and player entertainers. They are also normally on our server, and when you are very fresh, they will help you out with the first three buffs normally. So let's see what we have here. We have here a medic trainer, a marksman trainer, a brawler trainer, and a junk dealer. Junk dealer, we can sell some items later. I want to become a no-wise marksman also, because when we look at our skills, we have 250.3, and you can learn everything you want. When you don't need it, you go here to no-wise marksman, surrender skill, and the skill is away. That brings us not an advantage, but maybe some people wanted to start as no-wise marksman. Where we want to make later a little bit range combat. We will go also to the medic trainer, learn the no-wise medic skill, and when you take now a look here in your skill tree, you will see no-wise medic here gives us the ability we can craft our first stim packs, we can make diagnose on other players. We have the skills heal damage, heal wounds, so we can heal our own wounds. We can medical forage to get some items with 10 damage and 10 wounds that are instant skills that we can use. But we have here our stim packs A. We can go later to a vendor from players or and start to buying a stim pack B because they will heal a lot of more and will save our ass a lot of times here. Okay, and now we are prepared. Maybe we look a last time in our inventory. You will see here also you have a speeder bike. You can use it for later use, and when you store it away, it will be here under your, sorry when it's too fast, under your data bed, Control D in datas, and here you can call it again. You can also put it here in a button like this and call it and discall it here. Okay, here is our starter dungeon. And let's get back here to show you some combat moves. We have here our Mr. Meat Lump Cloud. It's yeah. I think he want to make troubles. Do you want to track troubles? Yeah, he looks like troubles. So we started our combat now with Intimidate. So when we make Intimidate, you see there was the symbol applied on him, and he have now here in his buff bar. Maybe we put it here. The symbols here for intimidated. It's this one. When we are kneels, we have here the buttons to stand up, and we will now use here our pole arm skill to hit him. During the while, I remove here the medic and the marksman skills because we don't need it at the moment. And what I forgot, we need to activate our macro because he hitting us and we don't like that. So we raise up our defense here a lot. Here we have our combat. I have pressed here a lot. You see, we need to activate here again. Stand. And hopefully we will hit him. We are very low with our speed because the stuff has a small speed here. So we need a while to bring him down, but you see, We are good with our buffs and our heals, our combat macro is working, prevent us for damage, and finally we killed him. So, we get now some items from him, no, only 70 credits. And we move around here to the next guy. We started with Intimidate. You can make also a war cry on him. And then we start to fight him again here. As you see, he has forced us to kneeling, then we can't trigger our skill. We need either to stand up or to push our arrow keys. So, we see here, after the first one, we have a good amount of experience for the starters. I think when we have hit them in the ground, we can go directly to the trainer and hit, learn some better skills here. So, please die now. We loot him again. Some credits. I will raise the loot chance that you get here also a little bit more items from them. And a small side note to all our old players. When I find here Jedi Padawans grinding, that's only a starter dungeon where I would only see starting players. If someone abused that, yes, you will take to a Rancor and they will eat you. Very simple. Okay, we are now here on our Brawler Trainer. And we talk with him. Interesting learning skill. We learned pole arms 1. Yes. When we go now in our skill tree to the brawler, you see we have learned this skill. We have a new certification, metal staff certification, reinforced combat staff certification, and the pole arm hit 1. We have also get here the abilities, pole arm accuracy, 10 points more and 5 points more speed, and center of being is now a lot of efficienter as before. So our defense is stronger, our skills better, and we hit harder now. All we need is the other weapon. You can look here in T, there are some player shops or in other cities which will sell you here reinforced combat stuffs. And maybe a side note, we go now to our inventory here, and I will use now on myself, I got target on myself with control 1, you see, we have now our 7 target, and I want a little boost here, because we have all the stim packs here, so I choose the melee accuracy that we hit even a little bit better the next 5 minutes. You see, we have here a new buff in our buff toolbar. So we walk already in the dungeon and we are back, my friends, hitting the crap out of you. And here's the next one, we intimidate. Here you see intimidate is online, the war cry, and we have here now our skill, and bye Mr. Meatlump. So we make that more, and I go a little bit in the basement. Here are also some meat lumps. Meat lumps are only for the starting here. That's only that you can make your first 1 or 2 boxes. You don't get here so much money, but you can learn easily your combat skills and also have fast access to the trader, that your skills, when you have the first 2 or 3 boxes, you are prepared for the wilderness outside. And I hope it's fast here, maybe 14 minutes, and you learn here on an efficient way the combat mechanics. You see, the intimidate is here worn off, so we make a new intimidate, because we don't want to get hit. And starting to hit him again. When you take a look on your skills, you have some skills who are affecting all button bar or all hum bars, heals, action and mind, or some skills make that randomly, like this hit here, it's randomly one time heals and focus and action. That's not very efficient here, so we need some skills later which go only on one pool, because then we are much faster with bringing the mobs down. And I think, let's try, here is a big boss. you see it's a leader boss, he have the braggarts, and then his name. We will try him to get him out. Maybe it will work. I think he's a bit harder as the normal ones. Let's see if we have a chance against him. Yeah, see, it's working. Our defense is online, we don't get so many hits here. Our buff is 2 minutes left from the accuracy, so we hit him a little bit more. And you see, we go to all three skills. We can also make here the lung. The skills have different combat modifiers, some give you for your attack a little bit accuracy. You can also make yourself a stand macro for the combat, same as the cop macro. Then you type in a stand. Then when they force you to prone, to kneel, you are always stand up. You can also make macros with timers. Like, then you get here a message for yourself, tell yourself here it's two hours are over, you need new buffs, for example. It's very useful later for your food buffs to make such macros. I think in our forum we have here a nice collection of macros, but when you googling macros and SVG, you are able to find a lot of macros for this game here. And you see I'm keeping all the time here this intimidate online, because then you don't hit. When I make here this one, and I have too many skills because yes, I press too much button, I can clear it every time, and so the other skills have a chance to come through. When you get new skills, some skills make bleeding, some skills blinded your enemies, some skills are area range. So maybe you look in the forum or ask the players, with the fourth skill in polearm, for example, I think you get your first area skill, and the bleeding skills later are also very useful. And so you should keep a good eye on all your skills. They are not all the time explained in the tooltip text. You need to learn what they can. I think that's a little bit hard here in SVG. So we have here something looted. And we will kill this one guy too. Well, let's take a look in our inventory. We have here, we got here a new enhanced ranged accuracy. Oh, that was fast. Okie dokie, goodbye. We have looted a work light. Work lights are junk loot. And now we go here to this one, and you see it's very fast, but they don't give us so many experience points. We are able here to make our first half an hour or hour in this dungeon, and then we should move away to better things. Oh, here intimidate wasn't working, so we try it again. Intimidate, and here is it. It's intimidated for a short amount of time. Let's hit him a little bit. With the next skill, our speed will raising, our accuracy will raising, and the chances of combat are much better for us here. The next thing we should raise is our medic skills, but unfortunately when I'm activating here the heal damage, for example, I need here to sometimes to here you heal yourself 104 damage. That's not so good. We need Stimpak Speed to heal us a lot of better here. So after the UB dungeon, the first thing you should do is go shopping, because we need, when we have the next skill, we need a better weapon here. And also I'm looking now here in our inventory, and when I look here you see our armor starts to decreasing. Armor is very expensive. Here we have here our skill screen. That screen means we can go learning on our trainer. So, yay, Mr. Trainer, we are coming. And the respawn is also not so good here in this dungeon. So when there are two starter players, it's overcrowded already. So be nice to them. And here we have our next skill. Okay, when we take here a look, we get 10 accuracy. That is now, for instance, when we look at here polearm, we have 30 accuracy, 15 speed, and our skills are rising. We have the polearm lekit, and here we will have a polearm stun, a new vibro axe. So let's make the next. Here's our, when we got not the icon, we can go here back in our ability and commands under combat and choosing now pole arm legged. You see we have also point blank, but that's for pistols and overshot and or for rifles and or for carabines. But when we don't use the weapon, yes, then we can't use the skill. So let's take a look. Here's our next victim, and you see it's not red anymore. It's now yellow because we are dangerous now. But yellow means also for us we don't get so much experience points as before. And you see it's starting now to get faster. And you see I have only hit here with a leg hit the action bar. So let's try this again and look only on the action bar. So that was the first hit on the on this action bar, and the next on its action bar. And like this. And you see it's a lot of efficiency with the skill, with the leg hit, only to use that because we only targeting one pool. This here is the action pool. Here he is not any longer with intimidated, and you see we start here to get damage. But so you can see that he is now there too. And you now you see yes, the XPs are rising a lot of slower as before. Let's take a look if here is someone left. And so it's only here for starters here. You see, bam, one hit, two hit, and then bye-bye, Mr. Meat Lump. Ah, we are kneeling, stand up, and bye-bye. We will loot him also. Let's take a look. We can also press Ctrl M for the map, and you see here the yellow dots. That are new meat lumps. They will respawn after a time. Intimidate, leg hits, and goodbye, Mr. Meat Lump. You see, this one is still red. That should be get us a little bit more experience points. Also, when you group with other players together in a group, you get a bonus of 50% experience points. So you level a lot faster here. So we are kneeling, and we are start hitting again with the leg hit. This part is now a little bit boring, but after we have here the fourth box, we are ready to kill the good guys. So you see, XP comes now in a lot of slower as before. But we have here in the starter dungeon our first two boxes. Maybe I make here noch some animals into this dungeon, which are a little bit harder. So you can stay here until you have the first three boxes full. And then we want to earn some money to buy us cool things. So we have cleared the dungeon. We have our first two boxes full. We are on the way to the third, and I think if you release that dungeon, you can stay here until your three boxes are full. We have also some junk loot, like this work-like, or this gong, or this basket. We can go here to the junk dealer. Junk dealers are in every city. Some junk dealers buying armor, some weapons, some jewelry. You can go here and say have some things that you might be interesting. And you see, he pay us nearly 2,000 credits. Yay! We are rich. And now we can start here to go shopping. A good way is on our server, very here in the near. Oh, let's call our bike. We stop here our macro. Then we call our bicycle to move some a little bit around. We have in our live server, when you cycle around this palace here, in front of the palace street are shops, where you get also your weapons. When you go here down the street, you are able then to shop on the left and the right side. The next thing is when you want to make missions, because you have a better weapons, then you can go here to this orange terminals. Here are the explorer. We need a mission terminal. And on the mission terminal, we get now some easy missions. I would make some missions that are not so hard, maybe here only for under 2000 the first one. And it should be around difficulty 15 and should be animals. Then you are very fast to kill that. You get your first layer money, and the animals are also now a little bit higher. And you get here a better payout and also better experience, like in our starter dungeon, where you learned your combat abilities. Then when you move here to this one, you can also go to the overhead map, like this one. And here you can search for junk dealers, for example. Then you get here the places, like here. You can go also for the terminals. I'm searching here bazaar terminals, like here. We make here create waypoint, then we get here this blue arrow. Ah, here is our here, you get, and you see it also in the overlay. And you can use here this terminals to find a better weapon for you. Then you go here, maybe only for this planet or only this region, but you need to go to vendor locations, because that's one are only the bazaars here inside the directly main market. You should go to vendor location, also either this planet or entire galaxy, and then you choose here a category, like weapons, for example, and you need here for pole arms, the pole arms weapons, or maybe you need the stimpaks. The stimpaks are under, oh, let me take a look, I haven't played long, I think it's under chemical. There you get your medicine, or here pharmaceutical, is it? Here pharmaceutical, you will find your medicine. Okay, yes, that's so far from our test center. I will adjust a little bit our starter dungeon, but I think that's the way you can go your first 15 minutes without any frustration and are prepared for your next 100 hours of playtime. Welcome on Revelation, guys. I hope that guide helps you a lot, and also the dungeon. Yeah, we will see you in game. Bye then.